We back with that bullshit. Leaving kids in cars, man? Damn, bro. Just listen to this and I'll be back with the commentary.
Good evening. We have breaking news tonight. There is an Amber Alert for a 2-year-old boy from Meek City.
Police believe he is with his parents, but that's why police are extremely worried about his safety. Levi Ismail joins us now live from Meek City with the latest. Levi?
Lake City police believe this is the last place that Malachi was with his parents at this home here in Lake City. And as you can see, from just our perspective, the home almost appears abandoned. There are no lights inside, no lights outside, and there's actually a for sale sign right next to it. So all indications point to the fact that these folks may not be returning. Now, this was back on June 5th when they were last seen here. And that was at the point when Malachi was supposed to be taken to CPS by his parents, Cody Bankhead and Catherine Ulrich. Now, a judge signed the order because of claims of possible neglect of the 2-year-old boy. Since that day, no one has heard from Malachi's parents. Now, Lake City police say they believe Malachi is in grave danger. They're calling on everyone to keep their eyes open for a 2015 white BMW SUV license plate KSW8656. Again, that's KSW8656. Malachi is said to have eczema on his elbow, while his mom has numerous tattoos and his father has a scar on his upper left arm. Now, here's another look at Malachi. Of course, if you have any information at all relating to his whereabouts or his parents' whereabouts, you're urged to please contact Lake City Police Department. Of course, we will keep you updated with any information that comes as soon as it becomes available on our website at khou.com and on air as well. Guys, thank you. Funeral of little Malia Davis. It's been 10 days since her remains were found in Arkansas.
It's so many missing kids. He was about to say Malachi. Y'all know that was what he was about to say. He was about to be like, oh, Malachi. He meant Malia. God damn, it's too much going on. Even her ankle's fucking up.
Allegedly dumped there by her stepfather, Darion Mintz, who claims the girl's death was an accident. New tonight, strangers are remembering the little girl. One man whose daughter was the same age as Malia did this, painted her name and decorated the fence outside the apartment where Malia lived. And hundreds of people walked in downtown Houston yesterday demanding justice for Malia. Mayor Sylvester Turner and HPD Chief Art Acevedo were there. The mayor proclaiming Sunday as Malia Davis Day. City Hall was lit up in pink. That was Malia's favorite color. Of course, we'll stay on top of this story that has moved so many people. They have a special section that provides constant updates on our KHU11 app.
Moment. But while their back is turned, someone else jumps in the car and takes off. It happened to a mother in Spring late last night, and luckily her child is safe, and a suspect is in custody. But a lot of you have been asking us, why don't parents get charged in cases like this? Our Lauren Tallarico spent the day finding out. A child kidnapped on accident during a car theft. What are the chances, right? Well, come to find out, it's not as uncommon as you may think. Over the past year and a half, we have covered at least 4 of them, all with kids in the back seats, all taken from gas stations. A 7-year-old taken in Southwest Houston. The thief caught on camera.
It was very scary.
Then 3 young siblings, all in the back of a stolen car.
I don't even care about the car. Just want my keys.
Even a 7-month-old baby sleeping inside a stolen car in Humble every time it happens. It's the same reaction from loved ones.
I was relieved and also happy.
Over the past 18 months, the 4 car thefts turned kidnappings that we're looking at all had happy endings, and all happened when an adult left the car running and stepped away.
She stepped out of her vehicle for just a few seconds.
Including last night's, when Precinct 4 Constable Mark Herman says a mom pulled into the Spring gas station to drop off Redbox DVDs. Then the next thing she knew, someone stole her car with her 4-year-old inside, then led deputies on a chase.
The speeds got up to over 100 miles an hour at one point. Our deputy kind of backed off of the vehicle, knowing that the child was in the vehicle with the suspect.
The thief ditched the car, and the little girl was okay. The suspect, a 16-year-old, was eventually arrested. Now, in all these cases, the parents or guardians weren't charged. So we asked Constable Herman what the law says. Can you leave a child unattended in a car? He says there but it's never a good idea.
I cannot stress that enough. I mean, this day and time, people will jump in your vehicle, they will steal your vehicle, and in this case, you know...